You need to engage Terminator mode. I did a video this morning about the Terminator. If you've ever seen the movies, you remember how amazingly relentless the Terminator is, but you can change it. This is your mind. So you can adopt the Terminator for good in your life. Eliminate excuses. Have the checklist in your mind around what you need to do to accomplish what you want to do. Have a big vision for your life and start to live it every day. Get rid of the procrastination. You get up out of your bed and you think, okay, I'm going to just do at least one thing today which is going to move me forward. I'm no longer going to overthink things. I'm no longer going to make the excuse. I'm just going to go boom. As Mel Robbins says, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. And just start to take that action, whatever's going to lead you. If you get tempted by things, remember, you are now living that life that you want for yourself. And that means you've got to be consistent with what you want to be. If you start going back on the things that you used to do, then that's going to have send a message to your brain that you're not in being consistent and congruent with the goal and vision that you want to accomplish. So be the Terminator, be relentless about the thing that you want to achieve, and you will achieve it because you are greater than you think. Your programming can be altered. The programming that you've learned all the things that stop you from moving forward. You've learned over the years from your environment, from the people around you, from the people who say it's not possible. People who say it's not possible have programming and they're passing this to you, and you think then what they think. Think about people who have done what you want to do, who are doing the things you want to do. Go and watch their content. Go and listen to them. Go and see what they went through to achieve what they want to. They became terminators of their life for good, for the thing that they want to achieve. And when they set their mind to it, they broke through. It didn't matter what happened. It didn't matter what barriers were in the way. They created a plan. They become resourceful. Just like the Terminator in the movies. He was totally resourceful, relentless about the thing that you wanted to achieve, i.e. we know what you want to achieve about Sarah Connor, and etc. So please, if you're editing this video, switch to the Terminator, you know, creating his checklist. This is what we need to do, but we need to do it for the good. Do the checklist for the good. So in the movie, when you thought it was all over, and in the very first movie where the Terminator got burnt and it was, you thought, oh, it was over, great, and then suddenly rose from the ashes. And that's what you do when something difficult happens. You rise from the ashes. You continue. You break through. You say, no, this is something I need to achieve. So when you are procrastinating, when you make excuses, you say no. You say, come on. You say, just do one more thing that's gonna make me shift my way towards you. And you can be proud of yourself. When you can be proud of yourself, even if it's, you know, just one thing, be proud that you didn't give in to the procrastination, you didn't give in to the excuse, you said to yourself that, no, I'm going to do this. So even today, I woke up this morning and I didn't want to go for a run. It was raining, but I went for a run. And now I'm sending that message to myself, no matter if it's raining or snowing or whatever I'm going to do, I'm sending my mind. And so during a day when I know I need to accomplish things, I can just rely on that. My brain's already said, you've done this before, you can do it again. And that's what programming is about. You're programming your Terminator mode. Terminator mode for the vision you want for your life, the vision you want to have, the reality. You want to bring it into your reality. And even this week, when I consume a lot of podcasts, I consume a lot of information. And even this week, we talked about quantum mechanics, and it got me really excited because quantum mechanics is something that I've just been introduced to. And it's about that the things that you look at, it's just our perception of reality, and there could be multiple types of reality. And the amazing thing was that they're explaining that I take one decision, but there could be another version of me taking a different decision, a different life. I don't need to think about it consciously as I'm going through my life, but to think that that is actually being researched and it's actually a thing makes you think, well, what is real? So if we think about how we can influence our lives, be the Terminator for the thing we want to do, think about that for a moment. Think about how you can influence your life and actually take those actions. When you take those actions, you're influencing your you're putting energy into the world and you're creating something you don't necessarily do. Today, again, I was challenged by someone called Mark Drager today, and he said, I've got to dance in the rain. I felt super uncomfortable. I am a dad dancer. I am a dad dancer extraordinaire. And I had to post a video of me dancing in the rain and it was super uncomfortable. My wife thinks I'm going crazy. My family think I'm going crazy, but the whole point is I'm teaching myself to do things that are difficult and uncomfortable for me. I thought it was uncomfortable, but I know that you wouldn't necessarily do it. But that's the whole point. When you don't want to do it, that's when you do it, because you're training yourself to do the hard things and pushing through. I'm being a terminator. I'm terminating excuses. I could have said, no, I'll tell you what, I'm not doing it today. I don't feel like it. You know, it's raining, but it doesn't matter. I feel uncomfortable. I'm not going to do it. I did it. And that's sending this program in my mind all the time, getting bigger, getting bigger things, working towards that vision, doing the things. And that's what I want for you. I want you to feel inspired. I want you to do it. I want you to be the terminator of your life and two or three. So how do we do this? Let's do a three-step process. So number one, pick something that's uncomfortable, not super uncomfortable, right? Because you may not do it, okay? Just something that's uncomfortable. I don't know what it is, like posting a video or actually putting a blog or setting up a Facebook page and just post it. Just post it, just to be a few lines. It doesn't have to be great. Most of the time, people ain't going to see it. They're just not going to take notice of it. So just go and do that. Number two, once you've done that, review how it feels. Write it down in the journal. Think, how did you feel when you did that? Did you feel proud of yourself? And you should miss any message that I did this and I'm proud of myself. And then number three, the next stage is to pick something a bit more uncomfortable and then build it up. And gradually, over time, if you do this a year from now, your life is going to look so much different. So I hope this has really helped. Three-stage process, I've given you that. Now, a lot of people don't action information. So I want you to action information, put in the comments below what you've done and do a hashtag Inspiration Nation. I'd love to know what you think. I'd love to know what you've been doing, and I'd love to know what you've been pushing through on. So let us know. This is Inspiration Nation. I'll catch you guys later.